Thank you for being here today. It's kind of our, really our kind of recovery concert from COVID, you know. We've had a lot of that going on, and some of the pieces we can tie into that theme, that idea. This first one specifically, it was written not intentionally connected to the COVID, but if you read the program notes, and again, the composer put this together with the idea he had found he'd been in his office in front of his computer screen composing and ordering food from the same restaurant, and things were kind of just mundane. He said, I gotta take a chance, I gotta get out there and do some different things. So that's a little bit of what he is alluding to in this piece called Cave You Fear. Sometimes you just gotta dive in. So whether we knew for sure today's conference was gonna occur or not, we were just gonna dive in, and we're glad you're here to join us. We'll start with Michael Markowski's Cave You Fear.
Thank you.
preparing this next piece, again, we want to blend and reinforce the sentiments of the composer, and her intent here is, again, to certainly honor those who are no longer with us. You know, whether in good circumstances or bad, they're no longer with us. And remember those might be moments that are a little bit stressful for those of us left behind, and yet music is one of those opportunities to reconnect. And so as we're doing this, if somebody in the back of your mind starts to come to the front, then we're doing our job. So, Julie DeRose, Hymn for the Innocent.
Thank you.
pays a little bit. We have some very talented students here at Midland. And I've got some of the interesting classes that have been practicing conduction. I said, guess what? I need to have a debut on stage. So if you would please welcome to the stage, please.
Thank you.
original John Paul II tweet in the early in the century. This is an arrangement in 1983, which they put together what they call flex band. So a lot of times we kind of expect a certain instrumentation. Well, not every school has that, or it, you know, that group of students kind of chose a group of instruments that's a little different. And so we could reorganize this particular arrangement with different groupings of instruments. And what's kind of cool, like I said, this was arranged in 1983 with COVID and all of those protocols. That's a huge thing happening right now. There's actually a number of consortiums of very well established conductors and composers that are putting together pieces so we can deal with this and still be able to, whatever combination might be at home, doing it virtual, doing different ways of putting it together, and using some of these flex band arrangements. Yet, this is not the very first time we've ever had a need for that. So this is that same idea. Just as a show of hands, how many of you on your part are playing part one? Raise a hand. Part one people. How about part two people? So you can see there's a mix of instrumentation. How about part three people? A few of those. How about part four? And part five? And part six? And percussion? But again, something a little different. You can see those different combinations. So, John Paul II by Jack the Bull.
Thank you.
with the Omaha Symphonic Winds. I have the privilege to conduct that group as well. That's adult musicians, probably ranging from age 18 to, I think, 87 in our group. And again, they were shut down during the COVID as well. They at least didn't really have a, a school to claim anything. We usually had the mercy of somebody else. And a lot of times they would join us on this program. They were not able to at this point in time. We're not quite up to speed there yet. But we had a few of our members that said, I've had my shots, I'm anxious, I want to play with the group. So I'd like some of our OSW folks to stand and be recognized. Al, and Kristen, and Rodney, and Amanda, and then a couple of other either alumni. Okay, alumni, Casey and Abby have joined us. So did I miss anybody? Roger Carroll? Don Carroll, okay. And then also Kyle Thomas. Kyle's joining us just today. He's a quick study, but our assistant director of performing arts here at Midland. So, I think we owe these folks a nice thanks for joining us. So, those folks, and again, just kind of filling out our instrumentation a little bit and kind of fitting things up the way we like to. So, we really appreciate them joining us. Hope you're having fun. All right, this is Scott Watson's extraordinary machine of clockwork and steam. I kind of like the pump, the steampunk motive of motion that's going on. And kind of fun. And so this will bring you back a little bit of that Jules Verne era and all of that. So there's lots of imagination, but it's also the challenge of how do we take what we've got and make something work. I was kind of curious. We polled the folks the other day and asked them how many built tree houses. Built tree houses, you can build them out of whatever you can find. I discovered these guys have not built nearly enough tree houses. They've got to go out and build some more tree houses. So we hope you enjoy Scott Watson's extraordinary machine, Clockwork and Steam. Thank you. firing job, fire job. Basement's cleaned out. I think Casey's available. Okay. So please welcome to the podium, Casey Noble.
Concert band
We don't think of as improvisation moments, but absolutely, those formal settings, all the way back to, you know, even Bach, Beethoven, all those guys, they would improvise based on some other thing. And so we've got Chris Lopez and Grant Francisco will be soloing today, but sometime during the semester, all of these folks are going to be improvising and working through some of those ideas. Getting used to a different concert band setting. So this is Omar Thomas's Sharp Dime. Music's great all the way throughout, so I hope you enjoy music from the Incredibles.